Hello friends, I welcome you back in this lecture series on fluid mechanics, where we were discussing the flow through pipes. In the previous lecture we have seen what is meant by flow, pipes in series and pipes in parallel, equivalent pipe, and power transmitted through the pipes. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about Moody's chart, what is the use of Moody's chart and how it is plotted, and how to find out the Darcy Weisbach friction factor using Moody's chart. So let us begin with it. So if you are not subscribed to the channel, you can subscribe it for getting notification about the lectures on fluid mechanics. So let us begin with the purpose of Moody's chart. As we all know that the Darcy-Weisbach equation for friction loss includes friction factor. So if I write down the Darcy-Weisbach equation, what is that? It is nothing but HF is the head loss in particular section of the pipe, is nothing but friction factor, that is particularly Darcy-Weisbach friction factor, into length of the pipe, velocity square upon 2G into diameter of the pipe. So what this equation is to find out the loss through the pipe by friction only. So if there is a pipe of certain diameter D, let us say this is the diameter of pipe D, and it has certain length L, and fluid is flowing through this fluid with velocity V, then what is the loss through the pipe during the flow? So what is the friction loss? So from section 1 to section 2, what will be the loss due to friction? That is the major loss that is obtained by this equation, called as Darcy-Weisbach equation to compute the friction loss. So very important part of the equation is F, that is nothing but Darcy-Weisbach friction factor, where F is nothing but Darcy-Weisbach friction factor. In many of the cases it is simply called as friction factor. There is one more kind of friction factor, that is coefficient of friction, that is generally denoted with CF, and the relation between F and CF is F is equal to 4 times CF. So that is Fanning friction factor. This is Fanning friction factor or coefficient of friction. This is Darcy-Weisbach friction factor or simply friction factor. So now the question is how to determine this for the given case. Now this is the pipe, I know the length, I know the diameter, I know the velocity through the pipe, but I don't know what is the friction factor in this case or in this particular pipe. So to obtain this friction factor, the Moody has developed a chart with the huge experimentation he has done, and with the Kohlberg equation, they have plotted a graphical representation of that data in nothing but the Moody chart. Now how to use that Moody chart to find out the friction factor? Now you must clear that. What is the purpose of Moody chart? It is used to find out Darcy-Weisbach friction factor. Next is now how to find that. So we'll now see the structure of the Moody chart. Before going to that, we must understand that what is meant by surface roughness. What is surface roughness? Because we know that if this whiteboard is there, it appears to be very glossy, it appears to be very smooth, but still it has certain value of surface roughness, means its surface is not 100% plain, it has certain irregularities. So if the surface has microscopic irregularities, these irregularities contribute to the friction. If the roughness value is more, means what? The level of the surface irregularities are more. You can see the rough mild steel pipe, the outer surface or inner surface you observe, it is very rough. But similarly, if you find a very smooth pipe, then the roughness value is less. So that is nothing but the average height of this irregularity is nothing but the surface value and surface roughness, and that is denoted generally with epsilon. So what is this? It is the height of the irregularities. So if I magnify this surface, any surface, if I magnify, irregularities will be something like this. Okay, So this is the maximum height, this is the minimum height, and average of them will be nothing but the epsilon. So what is the surface roughness value? It is the average height of the surface irregularities. Larger this height is, more the pipe is rough or the surface is rough. Smaller the height is, so the pipe is smooth. For the highly surface finished surfaces, the surface roughness value is very less. But for the rough pipes or for rough surfaces, the value is high. But again, there is next question that let us, I'll give you the example of two pipes. Let us say the one pipe is of diameter 2 centimeters. For example, the diameter of a pipe is 2 centimeter, and another pipe is there whose diameter is 20 centimeter or 10 centimeter. For example, we are discussing this. So let us say this pipe has 10 centimeter diameter. Okay, now I am using the same pipe material to manufacture this, and same manufacturing process, and surface roughness value is same. Means what? Whatever irregularities it has, let us say 1 mm is the epsilon. And here also epsilon is how much? 1 mm. Means what? Height of the surface roughness is how much? 1 mm. What do you think? What will be the result? What will be the effect of friction? Will it be same or will it be different? The surface is same. Both have same roughness value. But the diameter is more, diameter is less. What about frictional loss? Or what about the effect on the friction? You can think over this logically that since the diameter is more now here, the core fluid will be unaffected by the roughness. Because the diameter is more, so the core fluid will be unaffected by the presence of roughness. But here diameter is less, the effect of the friction or the effect of this roughness will penetrate towards the center, and lot of fluid will get affected. Comparatively, this will have get affected in the less extent than this. Okay, so this is, it means that it depends on diameter also. So you cannot deal or you cannot say anything, you cannot comment anything by only knowing the value of surface roughness. So that is why another term the Moody has developed, and that is nothing but the relative roughness. What is that relative roughness? It is the ratio of epsilon upon diameter. Means for that particular diameter, what is that epsilon? So if you find out this relative roughness in these both cases, you will find that 1 upon 2 centimeter is the, 1 means what? 1 upon 20, this is in mm. Both must be in same diameter, same units, so that get the dimensionless quantity. So what is that relative roughness? Very important term. You must understand the significance of this. What is the significance of this relative roughness? If you find out the relative roughness, then you can comment about this, okay? So if you find now here in this case, it is 20 mm. 20 centimeter means what? 20 mm. So what is this relative roughness here? It is 1 by 20. In the first case, it is 1 by 20. And the second example I have given, it is 100 mm. So what? How much it is? It is 100 mm. So it is what? 1 by 100. Yes or no? So it is unitless. So relative roughness in the first case is higher. This is more. And this is less. Yes or no? So this relative roughness is less. Means what? There will be less friction here. But relative roughness in this case is high. So there will be high friction here. So that is the significance of this term, relative roughness. Mere roughness is not irrelevant, or it is not sufficient to describe the situation. So we must compare that with diameter. With this diameter, how much is the relative roughness? How much is the roughness? And that is nothing but the relative roughness. So what the the Moody chart has done, they have plotted the experimental data conducted over different types of pipes, different velocities, different Reynolds numbers, and the all data is plotted along x and y axis. What they did on x axis, they plotted Reynolds number. On x axis, they plotted Reynolds number. On y axis, they plotted the friction factor that we want to find out. Whatever the experimental results they have got, they plotted that on y-axis, and on this other side of the y-axis, they have plotted this relative roughness. So there are three terms basically. One is friction factor that we need to find out, that they have plotted with their experimentation. Reynolds number, depending on this, we'll try to find out our friction factor, because as we know that Reynolds number, friction factor depends on Reynolds number also. In the beginning of this lecture, or while deriving the Darcy Weisbach equation, I have explained that the friction factor is the function of, it is the function of epsilon and Reynolds number. It depends on surface roughness and type of flow. If the flow is laminar, it is independent of this Reynolds number. So now we'll see how it is. So this on the side epsilon by d is plotted, but this is not horizontal everywhere. The curves go gets converged to this side. So if I plot constant epsilon by d curves, they found like this. So these are the constant epsilon by d curves. So on the any curve, the epsilon by d value is constant. Yes, and it becomes zero at this. Epsilon by d is zero. First line is epsilon by d is zero for smooth pipe. Means zero means what? The roughness value is zero. Means the pipe is smooth. So this curve is for smooth pipes. As we go up to the above side, what will happen? Here the epsilon by d is zero and the scale goes on. Yes, it is a dimensionless scale. If you want to take the roughness value in mm, take the diameter in mm. If you take this roughness value in meter, take the diameter in meter. If you take the roughness value in feet, you can take the diameter in feet also. That is not the problem, but the ratio of this same quantity has to be there. Then what we, this is the way they have plotted these constant epsilon by d values. Then this is the vertical lines are will represent the Reynolds number, and the horizontal lines will represent the friction factor. Yes or no? So if you observe, the Reynolds number below 2000 is nothing but what? Laminar flow, particularly critically is 2300. So for pipe flow, the critical Reynolds number is 2300. So below that it is laminar flow, and for that purpose it is independent of this all. It is simply a simple relation is there. F is nothing but 64 upon Re. Friction factor is directly can be obtained by 64 upon Re. This use of the Moody's chart is only for the turbulent flow. For turbulent flow only Moody's chart is useful, and it starts with the 2300 value. So this part of the chart is useless. After this you are going to use it. Now how to use this? I think it is clear now. On the x axis we have plotted, he has plotted Reynolds number. On y axis he has plotted the friction factor. On the other side this curve he has plotted as constant epsilon by d curves. Now how to use this? That is the question. So what is the purpose of this? It is the purpose is to find out the Darcy's best friction factor. So this will be output. So what is required? There will be two requirements. One is Reynolds number and second is epsilon by d value. So for the given problem, these two values has to be given to you. If they are directly given, then okay. If they are not given, you can find out Reynolds number with the formula that rho v d upon mu, where rho is the density, v is the velocity, d is the diameter, and mu is the viscosity. So with these values you can find out the Reynolds number, compute the Reynolds number. They must have given you the epsilon, you have the diameter, take the ratio in the same quantities. So you will be ready with Reynolds number and epsilon by d value. This is the first step to get the values of Reynolds number and epsilon by d value. Okay, once you got that first step, what is the step number one? Now I'll describe the process to obtain f. That is very simple. First step is to plot the Reynolds number. Whatever Reynolds number you got, for example, I will take that it has now 8000 value you have got. What is the Reynolds number? You got 8000. So let us plot that 8000 point here. On the scale, as per the scale, you will plot the value of Reynolds number on the x axis, and that is, let's say, 8000. I will number this as A, point A. Now project this point A vertically and name this as, I will name this for simplicity, I will name this as line AB. This vertical line AB, where the Reynolds number is how much? 8000. I have plotted this line AB first. What is the first step? To plot the Reynolds number on x axis and draw the line, vertical line AB. Now second step is to plot the epsilon by d value. So on the scale I will find out the epsilon by d value. Let us say this is the epsilon by d value. Okay, now I will follow the corresponding epsilon by d constant line. So if this is the constant line where the epsilon by d value is constant, if my value is somewhere in between these two, in between these two my value is there, so I don't have the ready-made curve, so I'll have to plot the curve parallel to the curves near to it. So I will plot that curve parallel to the curves near to it. So that is the resultant curve. So let us say this is my value, this was my value. So I plotted the corresponding curve which is parallel to the adjoining curves. So I got this curve. So let us say AB, I plotted this as C to D. CD curve is plotted. Now the intersection of AB and CD is my point. Intersection of AB and CD is my point. Let us number it as E. Okay. And now from point E, draw the horizontal line. Draw the horizontal line and project it up to the y-axis and read the value of F. That is your desired value of friction factor. So that is very simple. You just have to plot the Reynolds number, find out the curve for x1 by d value and intersection of them, project it to the y-axis, you will get the value of friction factor. So this is how we find out the Moody's chart. We use the Moody's chart to find out the friction factor. It depends on Reynolds number and it depends on relative roughness. Relative roughness is what? It is the ratio of roughness value of the pipe surface divided by the diameter. Now there may be a question that from where this value of epsilon will be available. Now sometimes in the numericals, for if you are talking about numericals, then epsilon is generally given in the numericals. If it is not given, the pipe material is mentioned in the numerical. Industrial grade of the pipe material is mentioned in the numerical, is generally mentioned. And that pipe numerical, if you know the name of that material, you can search that on this Moody chart itself. If you see the chart plotted on this side of the chart, this is the empty space where there is a table in which for the different materials, different industrial materials, what is the epsilon value? What is that roughness value? That is mentioned in the chart itself. So if you know the material that it is mild steel, so you go to the chart and see the mild steel name and search for that epsilon value. Once you got that value, you know the diameter, so take the ratio. Keep in mind that ratio must be of same units, and then find out relative roughness, find out Reynolds number, plot them, intersect them, project them, you will get the F value. So that is how we find out the friction factor using the Moody's chart. So I hope you understood this. If you have any kind of questions, please post me. Thank you very much.